prophet began to uplift the Moorish Americans by teaching them to be themselves, right? And then when you have studied and studied well, right? Right? Then is what? But if you say studying, teaching them to be themselves, right? That's simple. A person who don't read too well understands that. But once you study law, study nationality, you know it's in pro forma persona. You see? Huh? So, you see law dictionary. Now keep this in mind, concept-wise, and reason, and again, another reason why it's important, because even though people will move, everyone moves at their own pace of understanding. However, because of the real politics that's happening in the world, the people are going to have to start accelerating. Because what they're going to start doing is trying to starve the people. In other words, they're going to take people out of work, and they're going to try to kick them out of their houses in order to make you capitulate. You understand? But understand, the rest of the world already knows what's going to take place. But the people here need to know what's going to take place. They don't believe it. They really think these people love them. Do you understand what I'm saying to you? Or because they work for them. They're on a plantation. In their own land. Huh?
They're not going to get you people in this country what's being done to people in other countries.
They don't want the people. See, when you really understand, the people here have been given filtered information, which means they're under the concept that they're superior to other people. And so they think that other people are getting filtered information. Not that they don't, if you understand. The concept is that we're advanced. They have no idea that the world moves. It's like, for instance, like your sister was saying, you know, like you talked to, like when you know who you are, you'll see people even from other nations, Puerto Ricans and others, who tell you that they're Moors. You're Moors too. You know, Brother Rick Osan. He's Chinese, but he knows he's more. They got more signs than more Chinese. You understand that, to you? The ones who are asleep is these people here that keep trying to be somebody that they're not, holding up the planet. Do you understand what I'm saying? Because they put it this way. They complain about Rome, but they don't want Rome to fall. But they go to and fro the earth with our nations, keep going. Power, then come back here and do NAACP stuff, pee on me stuff, somebody else's pee stuff. Wish you could, if you could, organization, you got so many acronyms that produce absolutely nothing but drain the community with hopes, prayers, and wishes. Do you understand? And never give them a constitution to even read, and never give them their real history. While they got vesves in secret, making deals with Rome. You understand? And all of them get to the mountaintop. Slime. And you're the pledge. You see the one point. This is why that group is causing us so much trouble now. Now keep in mind, in propria persona, so in propria persona, Latin, jurisprudence, what's it mean?
One's own proper
person. In one's own proper person. Almost sounds redundant, doesn't it? In propria persona. Alright? So keep this in mind, keep jurisdiction in mind, alright? Alright? Keep your questionnaire in mind. How do we probably begin to live up with Moorish Americans? By teaching them to be themselves, right? So being yourself is being what? In one's own proper person. So in propria persona, and then sub juris means what? Capable of taking care of your own affairs, your confidence. You understand? In propria persona, it is a rule in pleading that pleas to the jurisdiction of the court must, that's a qualification, must be pled in propria persona, because if pleaded by an attorney, they admit the jurisdiction, as an attorney is an officer of the court, and he is presumed to plead after having obtained leave, which admits the jurisdiction. Are we clear? So you already know that the lawyers are members of the Barristers Association, and you know that King John of England made a deal with the Popes of Rome, i.e. Pope Innocent III, to be specific, with the Treaty of Verona of 1213, upon which the politics in the Western Hemisphere is built, including the Christian Black Codes, which was introduced into all the states when they closed the Freedmen's Bureau to deal with having these people thinking that they're free when they're not. Then they need some nigger leader preacher guys, and then they raise them in the lodges and have them marching these people around praying to keep them hope alive while there is no hope for them in these brains. So you can understand why they're not fired up about no withdrawal later. Do you understand? When you understand these things, none of this stuff is a mystery, nor the politics, nor the opposition. But you know how to counter because you already know what the motivation of thought is. Do you understand? This is why persons in positions of authority and rulership, including industry, must be Masons, because they must know what's really behind the veil, not what people believe. Because they don't deal with beliefs, they deal with the facts, but they promote beliefs amongst the ruled masses. Because you get out there and you do the work, you pay the bills. You understand what I'm saying? But when you know the truth, then you come at them different. That's why that judge in the East gets uncomfortable sitting in your chair. You understand? They're magi. You understand? So they must study the real history. So they're magi. So they tell you their magi strengths. You understand? But you know what's really up. And you're supposed to act, you know, enforce the Constitution. Being Moorish American, you are part and parcel of this said government and must live the life accordingly. Fine. Ex-relation. Ex-rel. Or another proper person. Therefore, if you want to make an argument, this is the deal when you're dealing with the straw. That's why they took the birthright. See, because you cannot be the corporation and not the gear, but on an information, because now you're a proper person. Now you can speak on an information on the straw. You can take what? Take authority. Yeah, that's that they're doing the E. They're doing that we call E. course they're not. Listen. What you're going to give them rights of indigenous people. So you inform them. Huh? Say it again. Then what you do, you write a complaint directly to the governor and one to the attorney general, notifying what they told you. What they told you, what you want to do is go back and you get what they said in writing. Or you write out what they told you and have whoever told you that sign it. Yes. See, no, it's the same thing. Now listen to what Bridget was saying. Like when you're doing an action in court and it's an appropriate persona and don't put it in a pro se, because if you're a proper person, they can't deal with you, that's why. See, because pro se, they can't prosecute it because it's not constable. It's not even in their jurisdiction. That's why we're going over this to let you understand what's taking place. And that you're going to get opposition. You understand? Now, the dealers don't think you're not going to get opposition, but to understand what you're dealing with. Do you understand? Because like if you're working for them, except for, this is why like when you see, when CFA registered the Zodiac Constitution in the Library of Congress, they have obligations. That's it. Yes. You know, whether it's intimidation and discrimination, but you gotta understand to make them angry because the point of it is they can't liquidate any property. This is what happens. When you're working for them, the tax that's obligated to the corporation, they transfer to you. They list your labor as income, which it is not. Yeah, but it is not income. So what happens is they have to start paying the tax that they're paying you, and the real deal, by law, they're supposed to give you the rest of that finance. That's what they don't want you to do. They don't want you to recognize that that's what's happening right now. Now, they probably think that you know that, even, but you may not know that. But that's really what's happening. So they're threatened. So they're going to try to make you capitulate. This is what happens. The corporation tax actually applies to their corporations and to the corporate state for operating in the Moroccan Empire, as expressed in George Washington's letter. They're doing commerce in the Moorish dominions. The stars and stripes is the amity and commerce flag. That's why they keep telling people it's the national flag. It's not the national flag. Red flag with 5.3 stars, the national flag. You understand? The agreement is the treaty flag, which if you see the tall cedars of Lebanon, i.e. the continental flag, continental United States, and the continental commerce. You understand? The national flag is the Moorish flag. That's why all of the rulers must be Masons. You understand? Because they're operating in the Moroccan Empire. They got your estate. It's just that they're comfortable and they don't want, you know, their trustees. Literally, they have the Moorish Empire in trust. They want you to keep thinking that they're national. You're the national. They're naturalized. This is why you see in the Naturalization Act of 1870, that's shortly after they begin to call themselves white persons. But that's why the law book tells you that they're not white people. This is why after the fifth edition, they start ordering everything down. And if you understand, you give different pieces of information so that your concepts can be correct, so you can look at this thing collectively, because you must understand the canvas that all of this stuff is on that no one speaks. You've got to understand the unspoken language. You understand where I'm coming from? So you have to know where motivations are. And so like even when you're doing things, just go ahead and keep using that name with that. Just keep doing what you're doing. Some time passes. Put things in place. rock the boat until you're prepared to rock the boat. Still, you, what they do, you still write your name as it is. You understand what I'm saying? But what happens is, this is what happens. They list you as Negro, Black, or Colored. That is the 14th Amendment. That has the sister cue, trust. You understand? So they mortgage you, your children, etc. All right? And what happens is that sister cue trust, they can come in and out of that trust for the benefit and don't have to account for the profits. This is why they must list the people as a minority. These are legal terms that effectively deal with the trust. All right? So what you want to look at is start looking at, you could even use a writ of discovery on the trust. Ask them to expose the trust, the trustees. You can break that down. That's why I did it the way I did it. You can apply it to everything. You know, don't even make a contention. Don't debate with them about that. Come at them a different way. You understand what I'm saying?
You're ready to sue.
Of course, but don't. In other words, unless you're really ready to sue them and you're secure enough, don't drop the book because you're in war.
But I can't give them my nationality paperwork now, then
go
back to the straw name.
No, you're not going back to the straw name. The straw name is an extra.
Right.
It's a business. You must understand it's a business. It is a business. It can never be you, and you can never be it. Do you understand what I'm saying to you? That's why, you know, when they come at you, like, you know, it's no debate. Just write up what they tell you and whoever told you. So, type their name on and have them sign it. You don't even debate, don't even push the issue no more.
So with that information, what do you do after you write that up and then sign it? And what do you keep?
Because they're not going to sign it. It's to give you experience that they know. You understand what I'm saying? But I'm just saying, and if you're not economically right now prepared, you understand, to take off and fight them to the limit and just do what you do. And be setting up everything, you got to set them up. See, because the world's coming at them, but you got to be ready to come at them. That's why you doing the paper. You understand, because the rest of the world seems like it's, the rest of the nations of the earth are neutralizing them to actually help you. But you gotta recognize that. In other words, when you read the rights of indigenous people, the Special Committee of 24, which we talked about before, that activity of decolonization, nationalization, was supposed to be working concurrent with that. In other words, those things are working together. But what has happened is that they haven't been teaching the people. You understand? You don't need to go out and make yourself a guinea pig, just start being active. Just start being active. You understand what I'm saying, teacher? And just by you starting to be active, it starts killing those instruments. Because you're not going to do it by yourself. Do you understand what I'm saying? So this is why this information is being distributed. The best thing you can do to empower yourself is to teach someone who does not know. And get them involved and make sure that you're open to what you already know that you're going to be blind. You understand? Nobody like this. You know how they say, Goliath is big. Don't think you jump in the ring for 2 minutes and then you're going to hook him a couple times and then he's going to lean over you. It ain't going to work like that. You know, like you said, you know, you didn't get in this overnight. You're not getting out of this overnight. So he's telling you strategy. You understand? So don't let, you know that you're right, but don't let your passion make you jump.
Yes.
You understand? You know that you're right. He knows you're right. But you're building up a paper trail. You understand what I'm saying to you? They ain't gonna pay you, but they ain't got nothing.
That's right.
You understand what I'm saying to you? That's why you always say, one of these days you're gonna be able to go look at the house and pick which one you want to walk in it. You know what I'm saying? But right now it ain't time for play. If you understand. But the people gotta recognize you're in a battle. You know, you gotta look at it seriously. I can't think because we're used to working for them, that we're still not in the mentality that this is our state. Although we know it data-wise.
Right.
Do you understand what I'm saying to you? They know that it's over. They got to put up a front. And so they, while they got some power, they're going to be trying to hurt you because they don't want you to wake up. Even though you wake. Because it will what? It's an avalanche. You got to understand, why is it that in spite of direct cause on the problems of the bank, they're trying to motivate again? Because it's done. They can't let it. In other words, it is, and yet they can't let it be. Yeah.
They are retarded.
Of course, and then some.
Yeah.
You know, like a brother called me from Canada, right? They punched in my name to get some information, and then linked right to the people in Georgia that took their millions of dollars of homes, you know. They're using different systems, but they're linking it because they know that they came from that rent. You understand? I have nothing to do with that. But they're linking it, so when somebody punches my name, that's what comes up around the world. All that.
You started that.
Huh?
You started that.
The Europeans do that because they call me the Fourth World War. They call me the Fourth World War. So they can misrepresent it. So they have people on Fox News act like they're trying to steal houses and all that stuff. They're trying to misrepresent it because they're trying to stop the momentum. Do you understand? You understand what I'm saying? It's a misrepresentation. But they're trying to stop the momentum. You know, they even took a strip mall over there, maybe had it for 6 months. You know, back to building the house and they were just taking it. You understand? And rightfully they can. You understand? But I know that some of them aren't national. They got the information and enrolling it. They've been studying. You understand? Some of them know stats and some don't, but the momentum is on. Including the whole European community down there doing the same thing. That's why they cornered that European and his son and then assassinated him on the street. And then they link all that. Rise and fall for all foreclosure are the United States Preservers, the Republic. They are the U.S. demos, democracy, for the postal rule, two different entities. You understand? When it comes to the Moors, we preserve these principles that built on the silver of the moon. When it comes to Rome, they deal with the fiat for the Jesuits to rob the people and to subvert the Constitution. And they know that people who know the government, as soon as you say U.S., they think that's real government. That's the criminals. You understand? And so since the people have been under Roman influence, it's going to take time to get the people back in the proper concept. This is, again, why this is important. Because this goes with functional nationality. So if you don't have this knowledge, it's collective other knowledge too, but if you don't understand this, you cannot properly function with your nationality. You understand what I'm saying? So even like see situations like that, it's still dealing with jurisdiction, but they're claiming personal jurisdiction and they're claiming subject matter jurisdiction and they're claiming Article 3 territorial jurisdiction, none of which they have. But because the sub-government and quasi-government agencies are operating under color in collusion, you understand what I'm saying? This is the only reason that's allowed to take place. You understand? So what you want to do is start beating them with questions. But let the overall do the work. Don't go out and do all the advice yourself.
I just
want to
start showing.
Yes, come on.
I just want to show a victory that we accomplished in Philadelphia. Every throw of the sheriff's office. That's from us putting in our writs,
yes.
Putting in our affidavits. And now there's a federal probe, a grand jury probe of the sheriff's office. Now he didn't quit, and he put another person in, but then they're still wiping them out again, you know, because. We know and we exercise, we're standing on our square now.
Right.
But this is what we've done, all right?
Collective.
Yes, collectively. We work hard at this. It cost a lot of finance and stuff like that because, you know, we had to work it out. You know, we shared it amongst ourselves to work this out, but we got this. We sent it to the UN and in Switzerland, because that place was up in New York, is not the real UN, you know. We sent it to the governor. Now, the piece that we got to work on is lean. Because I don't know if you ever heard of this European, his name is Charles Sprinkle. He put it in the YouTube. Charles Sprinkle.
I heard
him. He put it in the YouTube. What he did, every time they came up with a block, he came up with another piece of ball to satisfy them. What the key piece was leans. What you think's a lean on those people? Nancy Reagan, she was not happy about being placed up because she couldn't go to Bergdorf or Saks by herself because it was lean on her cats. So she couldn't purchase anything. But that's the piece, you know, learning how to be lean. That's our
issue. Yes. Not just that. And then, again, they started putting on us when the feds came in and shut down the office. They don't have a big connection, just like it did in Asbury Park. Well, Townsend became about 17 heads old. That's what that case was Grancy Dixon. But they posted it as dismissed the prejudice. But yet the feds came in the next month with 17 heads old. You understand? In other words, you got to start fostering them. They're not going to admit to things, but you have to be active and not passive. But your demonstration shows the world that you are becoming competent. And when the world backs you, but you have to stand up. They're not doing it. It's not a program. You have to be deprogrammed to get with the program. Because the rest of the world is already acknowledging you. That's why, you know what's not going to probably say to be recognized by the state government and nation when you live, right? The rest of the world already recognizes you when you start recognizing yourself. This is why Bush and Clinton then wouldn't sign the rights of indigenous people. That's why the Europeans are upset with Obama because he signed it. But they were already obligated technically anyway, because they're members of the United Nations. You understand what I'm saying? So, but they're upset because this represents it's over for them. Their advantage is that most of the people don't clearly understand this movement right now. You understand? But the momentum is already going on. You know, it's just that the people don't know it involves them. If you understand, because we're so used to being unimportant, you know what I mean, or reactive, that we don't understand the politics, much of the world's politics is reflected on us. It's just that we're not used to being respected by anyone else. We're always begging, because that's the training. You know, we're always begging, even in the gospel song, we're always begging.
Yes.
And the deal is, you know, it's like this. They're imposing, and they're going to try to impose, you know, to death, stares them in the face, because it's over. It's really over. And once you begin to recognize this, what you recognize. If you're complaining, marching, and protesting, and NAACP, and doing all that stuff, you spend thousands and thousands of notes with a whole bunch of leader guys that are Masons and really know the truth and ain't gonna tell you anyway. Really works for them. Got one foot in the back of the church and the other foot in the back of the White House. You're gonna sell the people out. Keep home alive though. You understand what I'm saying? But when you come at them understanding birthright, the documents and the questions that you present shuts it down. This is one of the reasons why we use the strategy of CCing it to other parties so they can, so because if you just deal in one department, right, they will try to bury it because they know how potent this information really is. You understand? Because it represents an avalanche. That's why when the Europeans and others start taking our grip and using it, that's why I shut down the banks in all 50 states. Come on. Yeah, and the point of this is what's happening. So a lot of the alphabet sub-quasi-government agencies of the feds are weakening. And so the states see that momentum of their fall. This is why you're going to see governors all across this country start taking a lead role and actually start governing their states more and more towards the Constitution to save themselves. You know, because it's over. You've got to understand it's over, but it's not just over like that. You've got to be active in order to save the next generation. In other words,
pressure.
Yeah. No, you've got to put pressure on you. Our real pressure is on us. Just be yourself. Being yourself is the pressure. You don't have to do anything to that. You don't see, you gotta remember, this is really what's happening. This must be really, really, really understood. You all have this. You understand this. I really need you to understand the purpose of this. And I'm going to finish reading this, then I'm going to go on to this. But I'm going to finish reading part of jurisdiction first, because I'm really trying to paint a picture for you. But I really want this understood, because in doing this, remember this. Remember on that grid, when you asked them for the deed of trust, huh? See, because when they do the mortgages, they set up a trust because they sell your name, they give you nothing.
Right.
They say it's a mortgage, but what they do is trick the people into signing a promissory note on a linear contract. Who knows what a linear contract is? Who else knows a linear contract? Y'all need to know what a linear contract is, one-sided.
Right.
You understand? Then they go and sell your name. They open up a sister cube trust, which allows them to go in and out of the trust. You understand? So in New York, they write a check for them immediately on the loan, alleged loan, quote-unquote, that they gave you, but they didn't give you the loan. This is why they can foreclose later, but they must trick you to think that you closed the deal. You didn't close it. In other words, you can't foreclose after closing. Foreclose before. And the reason they can foreclose on you later is because it was never really closed. Why was it never closed? Because they opened up a trust and didn't tell you. Do you understand what I'm saying? So then as a minority, that means you were mentality of little boy or girl. So they're dealing with your estate and they don't have to account for the profits or the estate or the body. You understand? That's why we tell people, look up minority and look up lordship tenants. This is why people understand wards of the state. You gotta understand, with no problem talking about me, you know why they coin those names, though they have legal purposes. They have functions. You understand? See, so they go in and out of that Sister Q Trust. So when you also in the any more seats? You can sit up. Any more seats? Bring some seats out. So, what's up? Yes! Exactly! You understand? So what happens is that they take in that trust, they also bundle the driver's license, the marriage certificates, and the birth certificates all together. This is where they do the algebraic derivatives on that trust. And it's unrevealed, isn't it? Undisclosed, isn't it? Undisclosed, isn't it? That makes it a fraud, doesn't it?
That's right.
But if you, I, or another don't know to deal with it or to even ask about it, it's like a waiver. Because if you're a minority and if you're black claiming to be, you declare it anyway, and then therefore you give them right as ward keepers. But understand, in the law of trusts, the trustees must report when you ask. That's why you do discoveries and disclosure requests. That's also why we wrote that written. To expand on it, particularly because people are using it all around the country and asking, you know, how to feel. And even though it's simple, they really need to really understand it, but it's out there in order to get the momentum. And knowing that, you know, unless you get them started, they're not going to get this. But if they get started, it's going to force them to study. You understand? But in the studying, what happens is Rome exposes themselves by virtue of countering you. Yes. You know, and this is why we tell people, you know, study, you know, take your time, but be firm. You understand? But understand, this represents, this is world doctrines, not just here. See, because when Rome falls here, the rest of the dominoes fall. Do you understand what I'm saying to you? This is why, again, many people in different organizations, when it comes to no quality, they get percentages. Get that. Get like that. Or try to divert the real reason he came. Or try to start arguing whether he's a prophet or not and start talking religiosity to divert your attention of what his real mission is, which is a social, esoteric, and political redeemer. You understand what I'm saying? And so if they can get people to look at him in some kind of spooky, pseudo-religious perspective, they get this whole idea of competing with the Prophet Muhammad, Jesus, and that kind of mentality, and they really psychologically dealing with a dogmatic perspective as opposed to the real science of what he's doing. See, but those who know law look at him as a scientist, not a pseudo-religious image. Because you can't be effective until you approach this information scientifically. Because you'll usually, if you're looking at it from the pseudo-religious perspective, you'd be all scooped up and you'd be looking at it all, looking for something to worship. Which makes you an illusion. You have no political power. You understand what I'm saying? But once you really understand this properly, you will have political power. That's why he says, you know, go out on my word. He said, I've given you more than enough to save yourself. Now go out on my word and redeem your people. Anyway, so persona of jurisdiction. This is persona of jurisdiction. In persona of jurisdiction is the jurisdiction of the person and involves the power of a subject, a person, or the parties in a particular class, in a particular class of cases, and that power to render decisions or judgments in such cases. In persona jurisdiction simply means jurisdiction over a person. Clear. All right. Now, being a Moorish American citizen of the land, the federal administrative courts lack natural jurisdiction to adjudicate any matters involving you. You are sovereign, and the legislative statutes used by the federal and state governments to persecute ignorant individuals do not apply to you. Nor were they ever intended to apply to you, the natural person. That's why they had to create the Negro, Black, and Colored and the 14th Amendment, which is why they warned you about it. It's why it's important to understand jurisdiction, to understand why he has that in the divine world. So you must know the truth and the divine truth. I'm clear. Now, all North Americans must be aware of the fact that subject matter jurisdiction, right? May be challenged at any time. Are we clear?
Yes.
Subject matter jurisdiction can be challenged at any time. It can be challenged before a trial. Are we clear?
Yes.
It can be challenged during a trial. Are we clear?
Yes.
It can be challenged after a trial. Are we clear?
Yes.
And it can be challenged even if the accused party has already pled guilty and has been duly convicted and sentenced to jail or to prison. It still can be challenged. Are we clear?
Yes.
Which means it's never too late to challenge jurisdiction, is it? Now, this is law. You understand? All right. Now, this rule of right is called the rule of right. Do you understand? It stands even if the accused is currently serving time due to a conviction. A jurisdictional challenge of this type is never limited. Are we clear? Never limited. So if any judge, any clerk, any prosecutor tell you, well, you can't challenge jurisdiction now because you didn't challenge the first time when we were tried, even we did it, don't even go for it. You understand? You just don't want you to know that. Because it's over. You understand? All right, so a jurisdictional challenge of this type is never limited since it goes to the foundation of whether the court had the authority to incarcerate the person or to even try the person in the first place. You understand? So now goes the status of it. So if you know you Moorish Americans, you know that unless they deal with you in a court of special sessions or a consular court, they have absolutely no jurisdiction even if they have it. Consular court because of diversity of nations. That's why in 1956, Eisenhower shut down consular courts when the kingdom on that side was relieved of Roman oppression. This is why they started making people think that Morocco was only on that side. Well, you gotta remember, Noble Ali raised the flag here in 1913 and went down there with the president and Coolidge and got the flag out. And they made them put the flag back in, the star back in. Then they started putting it into the encyclopedias again. And, no, that's not working, Wilson. This is 1925. Washington. They're wondering how they got in there. You understand? And then they start flying again. That's why I told the park on there. You understand what I'm saying? This is, has to go, this goes into the deception that people have, their perceptions of thinking Morocco is only on that side. See, unless you, secret society, you wouldn't know that. You'd be thinking, you know, you're in that mentality, George Washington was the first president, that James Monroe, Benjamin Franklin, John Adams and them constructed the Constitution, and all this whole stuff. But when you know the real history, you already know this, the Moorish dominions, you know that Sidi Muhammad, this emperor of Morocco, protected them and helped set this up to stop the wars between the Muslims and the Christians in order to save civilization. So you're part and parcel of this said government. Europeans can make you disconnect mentally so he can claim the estate. This is why the Knights of Columbus, Ku Klux Klan holding that took place in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, you understand, and also was known as the Mumbles Parade, Mums Word, the celebration in blackface here where you took your birthright, which is why they dressed on 6th and Moore Street traditionally. You gotta understand all these things that surround you. Parcel refers to a land. Partial refers to attitude. You know, and you're part and parcel of the same government means you're part of the state and the government. You know, and this is why he says, being Moorish American, you know, you're part and parcel of the said government and you must live life accordingly. He says, those of you who love a free national government, you know, he says, help me in my mission. And he tells you what the Moorish mission is. What does he say? To bring my people back into the constitutional role of government. Does it? Enforcing our Constitution of the United States of America. That means it's our contract with them. You understand what I'm saying? This is why they must take an oath before they can take office. Yes. This is why you think they don't talk about it, because it's over. They don't have landing. You understand? This is why the infiltration, in order to slow movement down. You understand what I'm saying to you? Yes. You understand? Because they don't want these Moors to start thinking international law. But you must do. You want to what? To qualify yourself. How do you want to deal with an estate and you don't know law? You don't know inheritance. You don't know how they took it legally. We ain't talking lawfully, legally. How are you going to represent or present yourself to the nation of the earth with your affairs, you know, when you don't even know what jurisdiction is? And they're claiming jurisdiction over your person, subject matter, and territory. Then our people keep calling them white people, which means sovereign. Then get angry when he acts like a sovereign. I mean, it's a lack of knowledge, if you understand. But the point of it, that's what the movement is for, to fix it. That's why every temple must have a school. Because the temple is designed as an outreach. The temple is right. You understand what I'm saying? So people don't understand. Sometimes they go to the temple and think, well, the temple didn't teach this. Well, the temple's not supposed to teach the way you're getting this. The temple has a structure. It's an organization. It's an order. The school is supposed to take you to your next degrees. You understand? What they don't tell you is that they stole the finance to destroy your school. That's why. What you understand that you don't judge, you don't misjudge the temple. Because a lot of people, you know, because of some of the corruption, have a wrong view of the temples. Because they have expectations that the temples are not going to produce. The temple's not wrong. It's just that they expose everything to you. It's not. You understand? So we're going to finish jurisdiction, then we're going to go on. And bring me back to where I was, too. All right? Before I went back to this. Now, keep this in mind. Now, the accused person must be properly identified. These are rules of right. These are 7 rules of right. Are we clear? Relevant to jurisdiction. All right, clear? All right. The accused person must be properly properly identified and identified in such a fashion and manner that there is no possibility for a mistaken identity. Therefore, the corporate entity versus the natural person must be established for the record. That's where your documents come in. You understand? And this is where, when the prosecutor begins to speak to the straw, you object and make sure that the record is produced and that whatever he has on that paper relates to the natural person, just like a third grader, and the baby, if she write her name, she gonna write the I case and no case. You don't let them write that corporation all four, all capital letters. Right? Now then, if they do, then of course, then you introduce the delegation of authority order and say, oh, I noticed, Judge, I didn't see your certification, delegation of authority order. It's not posted in front of the court. Well, is there a reason for that? You know, don't get angry, don't get nasty. Is there a reason that your certification for delegation of authority Article 3 is not posted at the court interest? Because is this supposed to be? Since, you know, you read rights. Plus, you've been cussing me out. Isn't the prosecutor supposed to do that? Now, if you're a prosecutor, and then you're the judge too. Furthermore, what do you tell me that's a good lawyer? Isn't the Barristers Association a member of the Lawyers Communist Party? And they go to law. Oh, here it is right there. I'm just showing you little things how to beat them.
I've been asked a lot of questions about a judge in Judge Small. So when we step in the courtroom, I'm taking a photo of him now, because he's national. And it's, I don't know how to handle it.
Yes, you do. He has an obligation on him. Does he have an oath? All right. Article 6, Constitution. Now, first of all, Article 3. Just because he judges and nationalizes what that means, still must be Article 3. He's administrative, isn't he? If he's administrative, he can't make any decisions. He can't even hear rationale. And not on the thing he's speaking for another party, he probably will all tell him. All right, now, so keep this in mind. So he must be properly identified, right? Number two. The statute of offense, this is where they do those statutes and those numbers and stuff. All right. The statute of offense must be identified by its proper legal or common name, not numbers. You understand? That's what you can demand of them. And a number applied to represent the offense is insufficient. You clear? That's number two. Number three. The acts of the alleged offense must be described in non-prejudicial language and detail so as to enable a person of average intelligence to understand the nature of the charge and to enable the accused a preparation of defense. Clear? Four. The accuser must be specifically named. He or she may be an officer of the court or a third party, but some positively identifiable person, a human being, must accuse, and some certain natural person must take responsibility for making the accusation, and not an agency, nor an institution, corporation, or artificial person, like the state versus you type thing. State's corporation can't speak, can't be injured. Foreign corporation is that. Right?
I had an incident like that. I went to traffic court. And I had an attorney, you know, this is 20 years, about 15 years ago. And I went there, and the attorney put the tape recorder up on the judge's desk. And the police came up, sat there, and goes, yeah, well, I can't really read this without the plan. I'm trying to work the law. And the guy said, I was going to use the law.
Exactly. Not just that, but knowing what you know now, you didn't need. not the lawyer, the administrative jurisdiction of the court, because the lawyer is an officer of the court, the judge is an officer of the court, the prosecutor is an officer of the court, and they're going to play golf together, send Susie to college over the finances that they're raping these people. And they're administrative, they need to have no judicial power. Nine times out of ten, the traffic court is speaking for another agency, which is a violation of the law. See, they can't even speak for another agency, but they know that the average person doesn't know that. You ain't got to get into detail, just like they'll say, oh, for the record, I don't want your transcript. Tell the guy, you speak for another agency. Come on, I'm here. Why just bargaining for sentence? All right, now, the accusation, this is number five. The accusation made against the accused must be made under penalty of perjury. So if they start talking trash, they say, yeah, you know, I saw a ride around like this and I'm saying, and it is more up there like that, man. So I stop. Let's go. Cop right here, right? Oh. Judge, don't come down and swear in. That's for starters. Now, since he's the prosecuting witness, and he wrote the ticket, isn't that conflict of interest? Did he give you a sworn affidavit and sign it and staple it to that ticket? Well, he don't need it. Well, yes, he does. I think he better throw it out. I'm just telling you so that you know that you don't have to argue with them. And then if they go through with them, he sued them, so the cop and everybody else. And the township too, for sick in that morning. Which is why you're learning to do affidavits, because you're going to be suing these people. Left, right, and their dog and their parakeet. You understand? So that when their wives start going to the mall, sticking their credit cards in, the suit's gonna go. They'll be standing waiting. That's wild. You understand? But we gotta make sure that they qualify. All of us. You understand what I'm saying? Now, so the accusation against the accused must be made under penalty of perjury. If perjury cannot reach the accuser, there is no accusation. We're clear. If perjury cannot reach the accuser, there is no accusation. Otherwise, anyone can accuse another falsely and without risk or liability of punishment. You see? Six, in order for the court or the accusers to comply with the five lawful elements as stated above, and as a condition for the accusation to be valid, the accused must be afforded due process according to the law, and the accuser must have complied with law and proper procedure and form in bringing the allegation of charge. That same principle right there, Sister Abigail, etc., same principle, sis, that I just read there, is the same principle upon which, like if they were to foreclose on a mortgage, the same information that you're asking for on that writ is what they had to introduce to the court to get a writ of execution in the first place. And if they didn't, somebody rubber stamped it, which makes them liable too. Not. Then they need some nigger leader preacher guys, and then they raise them in the lodges and have them marching these people around praying to keep them hope alive while there is no hope for them in these brands. So you can understand why they're not fired up about moving to our lady. Do you understand? When you understand these things, none of this stuff is a mystery, nor the politics, nor the opposition. But you know how to counter because you already know what the motivation of thought is. Do you understand? This is why persons in positions of authority and rulership, including industry, must be masons because they must know what's really behind the veil, not what people believe. Because they don't deal with beliefs, they deal with the facts, but they promote beliefs amongst the ruled masses. Because you get out there and you do the work, you pay the bills. You understand what I'm saying? But when you know the truth, then you come at them different. That's why that judge in the East gets uncomfortable sitting in your chair. You understand? They're magi. You understand? So they must study the real history. So they're magi. So they tell you their magi strengths. You understand? But you know what's really up. And you're supposed to act, know enforce the Constitution, be a Moorish American, you are part and parcel of this said government and must live the life accordingly. Prophet began to uplift the Moorish Americans by teaching them to be themselves, right? And then when you have studied and studied well, right? Then is what? But if you say, study, teaching them to be themselves, right? That's simple. A person who don't read too well understands that. But once you study, study law, study nationality, you know it's in pro forma persona. You see? Huh? So, you see law dictionary. Now keep this in mind, concept-wise, and reason, and again, another reason why it's important, because even though people will move, everyone moves at their own pace of understanding. However, because of the real politics that's happening in the world, the people are going to have to start accelerating. Because in what they're going to start doing is trying to start to be propria persona, Latin, jurisprudence, what's it mean?
One's own proper
person. In one's own proper person. Almost sounds redundant, doesn't it? In propria persona. Alright? So keep this in mind. Keep jurisdiction in mind, alright? Alright? Keep your questionnaire in mind. How do we probably begin to live up with the Moorish Americans? By teaching them to be themselves, right? So being yourself is being what? In one's own proper person. So in propria persona, and then sub juris means what? Capable of taking care of your own affairs, your confidence. You understand? In propria persona, it is a rule in pleading that pleas to the jurisdiction of the court must, that's a qualification, must be pled in propria persona. Because if pleaded by an attorney, they admit the jurisdiction as an attorney is an officer of the court, and he is presumed to plead after having obtained leave, which admits the jurisdiction. Are we clear? So you already know that the lawyers are members of the Barristers Association, and you know that King John of England made a deal with the Popes of Rome, i.e. Pope Innocent III, to be specific, with the Treaty of Verona of 1213, upon which the politics in the Western Hemisphere is built, including the Christian Black Codes, which was introduced into all the states when they closed the Freedmen's Bureau to deal with having these people thinking that they're free when they're... In other words, they're going to take people out of work. They're going to try to kick them out of their houses in order to make you capitulate. You understand? But understand, the rest of the world already knows it's going to take place. But the people here need to know it's going to take place. They don't believe it. They really think these people love them. Do you understand what I'm saying to you? Or because they work for them. They're on a plantation. In their own land. Huh?
They're not going to get you people in this country what's being done.
They don't want the people. See, when you really understand, the people here have been given filtered information, which means they're under the concept that they're superior to other people. And so they think that other people are getting filtered information, not that they don't, if you understand. The concept is that we're advanced. They have no idea that the world knows. It's like, for instance, like your sister was saying, you know, like you talked to. Like, when you know who you are, you'll see people from other nations. Puerto Ricans and others will tell you that they're Moors. You're Moors too. You know, brother Rick Osan. He's Chinese, but he knows even more. They got more signs jumping on China. You understand that, dude? The ones who are asleep is these people here that keep trying to be somebody that they're not, holding up the planet. Do you understand what I'm saying? Because they put it this way. They complain about Rome, but they don't want Rome to fall. But they go to and from the earth with valor nations, keep going in power, then come back here and do NAACP stuff, pee on me stuff, somebody else's pee stuff. Wish you could, if you could, organization, you got so many acronyms that produce absolutely nothing but drain the community with hopes, prayers, and wishes. You understand? And never give them a constitution to even read, and never give them their real history. While they got vesves in secret, making deals with Rome. You understand? And all of them get to the mountaintop. Slime.